Hello everyone, welcome to our UI UX video series. Today we have got a valuable video for those of you preparing for a UI UX interview. We will be discussing how to handle those tricky questions and provide the best answers to showcase your skills and expertise. Let's dive right in.
UI design versus UX design.
When you are preparing for a UI UX interview, one of the first questions one might ask is, what's the difference between UI design and UX design? First of all, let's clarify the definitions. UI design, in other words, user interface design, focuses on the look and feel of a product. Think of it as the front end of the design. On the other hand, UX design, which stands for user experience design, is about the overall experience a user has while interacting with the product. It's the behind the scenes part of design. Now, here's the key point. UI and UX are closely connected and they work together. So when answering this question, remember that UI focuses on visual and interactive elements while UX is about the overall user experience.
Conducting user research.
User research is the backbone of great UI UX design. It helps designers understand the needs, preferences, and pain points of their users. So when asked this question, talk about your research plan, recruitment, data collection, analysis, and sharing insights.
User persona.
What exactly is a user persona? Well, in the world of UX, a user persona is essentially a detailed fictional representation of your ideal user. It's like creating a character in a story, but for design purposes. Next, why is it important in UI UX design? So, user personas help to humanize the design process. They allow creation with a specific individual in mind rather than designing for a faceless crowd. And it enhances collaboration among design teams. When everyone knows who they are designing for, it's easier to align on design goals and make consistent choices. So, when asked this question, first give your definition about what's a user persona and next move to why it's important.
Your favorite examples of good UX.
What are they really asking for? They want to know whether you understand the elements of a good UX. So, when you're faced with this question, remember this. Knowing why good UX is important is one thing. Knowing how to design good UX is another. This question digs into your knowledge of UX best practices. So, when asked about your favorite examples, think beyond just visually appealing designs. Start by mentioning products or apps that have left a lasting impression on you. It could be anything from a mobile app or website or even a physical product with an exceptional user interface. Think of example ahead of time, what elements of the product, app or website make the user experience enjoyable. How is the design user-centric? How do you think that impacts the company's bottom line? Remember, the key is not only to mention the examples, but also explain why you consider them good UX.
Design pattern.
So what's a design pattern? Think of it as a puzzle piece that fits seamlessly into your design, making your work more efficient and user-friendly. Now let's talk about how you use design patterns in your work. Here's an example. Let's say you are designing a navigation menu. Instead of reinventing the wheel, you did choose a well-established design pattern for navigation menus. This not only saves time, but also provides users with a familiar experience. So, to answer this question, you can say a design pattern is a proven solution to common design challenges and you use it in your work by identifying and implementing these patterns to create effective user-centric designs.
Staying updated with UI UX trends.
Remember, staying updated with UI UX design trends is an ongoing journey. By following these steps, you will show your potential employers that you are committed to delivering the best user experiences. So, I'll give you some tips and tricks. First, follow industry leaders and blogs. Keep an eye on websites, UX design to stay in the loop. Second, engage with the design community on platforms like Dribbble, Behance, and LinkedIn. Join discussions, share your work, and connect with other designers. Third, use social media wisely. Follow design-related accounts on X, Instagram, and YouTube. Set up Google Alerts for UX design keywords to get email updates. Lastly, never stop learning. Invest in courses and books. Stay curious and practice what you learn. That's how you impress interviewers with your dedication to staying updated.
Tools used for UI design, prototyping, and collaboration.
When answering this question, remember to highlight your proficiency in industry standard tools like adobexd, Figma for design and prototyping. And don't forget to mention the collaboration tools you prefer. Demonstrating your toolset knowledge and its suitability for the job can leave a strong impression during your UI UX interview.
A challenge at work that you overcame.
Remember, this is a classic question, and your response can make or break the interview. Let's see how you can tackle this question effectively. Start by clearly identifying the challenge you faced. Maybe it was a tight deadline, conflicting feedback, or a design roadblock. Could be anything. Next, explain the context. Provide context by explaining your role and the project you are working on. Then, describe your approach to tackling the challenge. Did you conduct user research, collaborate with team members, or explore alternative solutions? Whatever you did. Next, explain how you overcame the challenge. This is the core of your response. Share specific actions, strategies, or tools you used. And discuss the positive outcomes of your efforts. Did the project succeed? Did you meet the deadline? Be sure to highlight the impact of your actions. Lastly, reflect on what you learned from the experience. This shows that you are adaptable and open to growth. Remember, your response should demonstrate your problem-solving skills, teamwork, and adaptability. Alright guys, that wraps up our discussion on some essential UI UX interview questions. I hope you found this video informative and valuable in preparing for your upcoming interviews. If you have any specific questions or need more guidance, please don't hesitate to drop them in the comment section below. See you in the next video.